America's tragic school shooting has sparked a huge turnout at a gun buyback. Our US correspondent Daniel Sutton went along to the event in Los Angeles, and you'll be amazed at some of the weapons he saw.
To Australians, it's a familiar sight. But in the US, a gun buyback is still a relatively unusual event.
We total almost about 1,600 guns.
Today, in an LA car park, people waited 4 hours to swap guns for grocery gift cards.
We're handing in a rifle and a handgun.
He's an NRA member, but also a dad, who watched the Sandy Hook school shooting unfold on TV.
That's the real reason why we're here. They've done these gun backs for years, and this is the first time us ever coming.
Owners could earn more selling to a gun dealer, but then these weapons would still be on the streets.
If you sell them out, some criminal might get a hold of it and kill somebody.
The guns handed in today range from handguns to regular rifles, assault weapons, but the biggest prize find of all, a rocket launcher. Somebody just drove up, opened up their boot, and handed this over.
All will be destroyed, but the US love affair with guns remains. Social media is buzzing with pictures of Americans showing off their Christmas gifts. And a small newspaper has caused a stir with an online map showing the names and addresses of every handgun permit holder in its area.
They were telling burglars, go to the house next door. They're not likely to have a gun because they don't have a permit, which is required.
Gun laws have even tripped up TV host David Gregory.
Here is a magazine for ammunition that carries 30 bullets.
A clip that's illegal in Washington, D.C., where his show is filmed. Police are now investigating. In the United States, Daniel Sutton, 10 News.